Hello. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about a very common problem in ladies, that is urinary tract infection. Why does it take place? And when we have to make a diagnosis of urinary infection, how should you collect the sample of urine for its culture and sensitivity testing? The urinary tract infection influences all age groups in female sex, the young girls, the adolescent girls, married ladies, childbearing age group, as well as postmenopausal ladies. All ladies are more prone to have urinary tract infection. Why ladies are more prone to infection? Because if you see their urinary tract and urinary bladder, their urethra is very short, and behind the urethral orifice lies female genital tract, the vaginal passage, which is often contaminated by bacteria, and these bacteria can trickle down in large number in external genitalia. In some females who are chronically constipated, the bacteria can grow in the stool and then trickle down through the anal verge and contaminate external genitalia and also the area around the external urethral orifice. So female genitalia is usually contaminated by bacteria, and whenever there's an opportunity for bacteria, it gains access into urethral orifice, and then it traverses the female urethra. Because female urethra is a very short passage, it is easy for the bacteria to travel. The bacteria goes inside the urethra and then goes inside the urinary bladder, where it can multiply in large number, and then it can get attached to the lining of urinary bladder and create infection. So this is why the female get urinary infection very commonly. The point to ponder upon in this video is, when you suffer from urinary infection, your doctor will ask you to collect your urine sample for a test called culture and sensitivity. Why do we need this test? We need this test, first of all, to know which kind of bacteria has infected your urinary tract. Commonly, over 90% of ladies develop urinary infection because of a bacteria known as Escherichia coli, commonly known as E. coli. But some women can have infection due to another type of bacteria called Proteus. And some ladies can have infection because of a bacteria called Pseudomonas. This causes sometimes life-threatening urinary infection. Sometimes some ladies can have infection due to another organism called Klebsiella. So you can have infection on account of any of these four bacteria. Why do we need to know this? Because each bacteria is killed by a specific type of antibiotic. So we get a clue for the choice of drug when we know which bacteria is infecting your urinary tract. The second thing we want to know from urine culture test is, what is the quantum of bacteria, the bacteria load inside your urinary tract? Because in urinary tract you can have 4, 8, 10, 15, multiple number of bacteria in urinary tract. So by culture test, we take the sample and inoculate it in a petri dish and let the bacteria grow. This is called colony count. So by the second part of culture report is the colony count. And the third part of culture report is the drug which will be beneficial to kill your bacteria. So I hope you've understood that a urine culture sensitivity test is of paramount importance for us as a clinician and for you as a patient. When doctor asks you to collect a urine sample for culture and sensitivity, you have to take lot of precautions. The first precaution is that you must clean your external genitalia and area around the urethra very nicely before you start giving the urine sample. This is because I just told you a little while ago that female external genitalia is usually contaminated by various bacteria from vagina or rectum. If you don't wash your external genitalia thoroughly, these bacteria will go in the urine sample and will contaminate the urine sample. So, what precautions you should take so that your sample collection does not become erroneous sample and you don't get a meaningless report? Because if that happens, your time and energy will go waste, your money will go waste. Therefore, I wish to tell you what precaution you should take when giving your urine sample for culture and sensitivity. Firstly, collect a sterile container from any reliable pathology lab. Don't collect a bottle which is lying for a very long time. Then you find a toilet with proper privacy and you wash your hands thoroughly, outside, inside, meticulously with soap and water, and dry them with a towel. Then next, you have to clean your genitalia. For that, you can use sterile wipes which are available in the market commercially. At one point of time, you will have to take three wipes. So with one hand, you open the external genitalia and with another hand, take one wipe first, clean the area around urethral orifice and genitalia thoroughly, discard that wipe. Take second wipe, clean the genitalia again, same place again, discard it, and then take third wipe and clean area around the urethra, area around the genitalia nicely. So thus, you use three wipes at one time. In case you do not have access to the sterile wipes, you can use any medicated liquid soap in your house to clean your genitalia. So take few drops of medicated soap on your hands, apply thoroughly on your external genitalia, area around the urethral orifice, vaginal area, rectal area, clean the perineum very nicely, and then do not forget to mop it dry by towel or tissue paper. Because if the area is wet and as you start collecting urine sample, some drops of water can trickle inside the container and will contaminate the urine sample. So make sure that your genital area is very dry. As you start passing urine, let the initial part of stream go waste. Let initial 10, 15, 20 ml go down in the toilet seat. And once that has happened, then you bring the opened container in front of the stream so that you are able to direct stream directly into the container. When you are doing that, take precaution that you don't spill the urine on the outer side of the container, because in that the container becomes wet and it can become slippery. After you have collected 10-15 ml of urine sample in the container, you should cap it properly and screw the cap tightly so that it does not leak. Next, you transport this urine sample to the pathology lab as soon as you can. Don't keep the bottle in your house for a long time, or don't waste your time, because if you do so, the urine will remain stagnant in the bottle and the number of bacteria can gradually increase and your report will become erroneous. If you live far away from the pathology lab, it is better that you go to the lab and collect the urine sample in the toilet of the lab itself. About the report of urine culture insensitivity, I must tell you that you will get this report ready in 48 to 72 hours. This much time is taken for bacteria to grow in the petri dish and then the technician to see which drugs can be effective against the bacteria. So don't push your technician or the lab or the staff of the lab to give you urine sample report very soon, very early. When you get the reports in your hands, don't try to interpret yourself. Let this job be done by the doctor who knows about you and your disease. if you read the report yourself and start self-medicating, you will harm yourself. So I'm sure you must have understood what precaution you should take while giving your urine sample for culture and sensitivity and the rationale behind these precautions. Thank you.